Thank you. Oh. A reminder to you that next week we will sing another High Mass. We will celebrate the feast of Saint Benedict, the patron saint of the Benedictine order, the founder. And so we will have that privilege of a High Mass. Again, I remind you also that there will be a social in the upper hall. And you are all, of course, invited to attend. It will be in celebration of my silver jubilee of monastic profession, and that is from 2:30 to 4. At 4 o'clock, we will return here to the church for sung vespers and benediction of the Most Blessed Sacrament. Also, I will ask you, dear people, to remember most kindly Michael Thomas, who is acting as our thurifer today. Mike is from St. Bernard's Parish in Hastings, just a few miles over the hill. And he will be leaving us to enter the Benedictine Monastery of St. Mary's in Morristown, New Jersey. He will be leaving on Friday, and he will begin his journey in monastic life. He will enter as a postulant, preparing to enter for the novitiate. So let us promise him our prayers, let us keep him in our prayers so that he may persevere, and that what God has brought to its beginning in him may be brought to its right and proper conclusion. May he become a true son of Saint Benedict. We offer the Holy Mass today for all the holy souls in purgatory. Now, my dearly beloved in Christ, there are two times when we will see the multiplication of loaves, of fishes. The first time is most definitely for us that understanding and introduction by our Lord into the Eucharist. The one that we have before the ears of our hearts today is, of course, a Eucharistic prefiguration. However, it is also for us something a little extra, because our Lord speaks today about those who are hungry and who will have to go on a journey. And so we can look at the Eucharistic reference that is here for us today as that which is for the viatores, for the wayfarers. So the Eucharist is seen as food for the journey. And so rather than thinking in terms of Eucharist and this celebration and the Holy Sacrifice, which is about to take place, we need to think instead of the end times, of viaticum, that which is given to the viatores. That is the food that is for the journeyers. And so our Lord is speaking, we should say, as a prefiguration of also another way for this Eucharist to be able to be given. It is for those who hunger and who will have to make that long journey into the kingdom. And yes, our Lord indeed wants everyone to be fed. So much so that these are not the small baskets that were spoken of in the first multiplication, but the words from Scripture directly to us indicate that the baskets were voluminous. They were gigantic baskets that were filled after this particular feast, which might again indicate to us that there should always be something left behind for us as we continue on the journey. And so we turn our eyes to the tabernacle and we think of the sacred host that is always reserved there for us, so that when the call should come in the middle of the night to the rectory, someone is dying, quickly our Lord is taken from that tent, that tabernacle, and he is taken to the person who is preparing to depart for their last journey. And so the journeyer receives the food for the journey. Our Lord wishes to make sure that we are tended to and that we are well fed and nourished so that the journey can indeed take place. And so it is only right and proper that we who are here for the Holy Sacrifice will partake of the meal that is offered to us from the sacrifice. We will eat the Christ who is sacrificed for us under the appearance of bread, under the appearance of wine, and it shall be nourishment for our souls and for our bodies. But we must remember always that how small the wafer will not give us much nourishment, but how tremendous the grace that is contained therein and then of the worthy reception. And receiving worthily prepares us when we will have to make that last journey from this life. This Mass will end and you will go in peace and you will walk out the doors into the world. You will return to your homes. You will return to your works. But someday you will have to return to your Lord and stand forth for your judgment, as will each and every one of us. And as we make that arduous journey in the last moments of our lives, it is only right and proper that the very Christ who walked the face of this earth and gave us himself would yet again offer to us body and blood, soul and divinity, so that we may be nourished for that last journey, taking us to the gates of the kingdom of heaven. Let us pray, dear people, that all of our receptions of the Eucharist may always be right and proper. Let us pray that they always be reverent and pure, let us pray that we offer them always for those who have forgotten the truth about the Eucharist, those who have turned their backs upon it. Let us pray, dear people, that our worthy reception of Christ will reignite the flames of Christ's love in the hearts of those who have become tepid or even antagonistic. Let us pray, dear people, that we might all be fed after the sacrifice has been offered. And let us pray that all those who need to be fed may feel the effects of the grace coming from this holy place and this sacred action this day.
Oh. Conscious and Domine non supplicius. Domine non supplicius. Domine non supplicius.
Thank you.